All right, welcome back to the SSL Family Dad channel. We are here in the tiny room, as we call it. It's the smallest room in our house. It's about 8 feet by 11 feet, give or take a few inches. And so it was a very small space. When we first moved into this house, this is one of the first renovations that we tackled. We have my oldest daughter, who is now just off to college. Can you believe it? We needed more room, and this room was just so small. You could barely have a bed and a dresser, and it had a closet in it, and it was all painted pink and had chalkboard paint in, all these things. And we just tore this place apart and totally renovated it, built the loft in here, put some LED lights in and a few other features for storage, and took the closet out, redid flooring and painted and all these kinds of things. And so I thought I would give you guys a tour. I've never actually done a final tour, and so I thought I would give you guys a tour of this room, what's held up well, what hasn't, what we like, what we don't like, answer some of the most frequently asked questions about the tiny room renovation. We get a lot of views on this series, and so I thought I would just take a few minutes and answer some questions, give you guys an update on the room. So we're going to go through and kind of look at what we have, what we put together here, and how everything's doing. So as you walk in the room, you notice everything is black and white. That was the theme that she wanted, and it gives kind of a nice clean look. And so we put new hardware and everything, these quick set handles, which were all purchased on Amazon, as well as all new black hinges. So we got the brass looking stuff out of here and put all black stuff in, which these have been really nice door fixtures and have worked out really, really well. In the front of the room, we mounted a TV up on the wall. This is just a smaller, it's not a smart TV. We put an outlet right in the wall here. This was run through the wall from an outlet down below for power for this. And this is one of those outlets. Again, we got this on Amazon that gives you that nice recessed look. So these plugs kind of stay out of the way so the TV can fold in here pretty tight. And we put an Apple TV hooked up to this TV so that we've got access to Netflix and Amazon and all that stuff. Of course, now we may replace that with a smart TV and just update that a little bit to a bigger size, but we can use the same mount and everything that we put on there. So, but that's been working out really well. There is one window in this room. It's a pretty good size window, and we've curtained that off with white curtains and a white vent, of course, for the heating system that's down there. And all of this flooring is it's a cheap floor. It's not a real hardwood or anything like that. I think this was a hickory look. I'll actually put a link to this in the description over on Home Depot is where we got this from. But this has been a very solid floor. I'm not a huge fan of these, I don't know what you want to call it. It's basically MDF. It's a sawdust board with a surface on it that's textured and printed on. But it has been very, very durable. The kids have been in here beating this up, and doesn't have any really scratches on it. They've spilled water in here quite a few times, and I haven't seen any puffing up of the cracks or anything like that where water's made its way in. And we had a fish tank in here, and there was lots of splashes and other things, and again, kids spilling things on the floor and stuff. And it has held up really well. It is a cheap floor, and so it's probably not going to last 100 years or anything, but this stuff has done pretty well. So one of the main features of the room was we took the closet completely out. The closet used to be back in that corner. It took up a bunch of space, and so instead we replaced it with these stairs that lead up to the loft. This was made, and I'll link to all these videos, but this was made with all 3/4 inch plywood and built in a way where everything is joined together, so that all the weight of this whole entire staircase is resting fully supported on these pieces here with very few fasteners. There's only screws really on the corners pieces. All the screws were covered with drywall putty or drywall stuff and then painted over, and that held up pretty well. Looks like we have one here that I didn't do a very good job on, but the rest of them turned out pretty good. And so this space, instead of having a dresser or a closet, is where basically all of those things are stored. So, all the things you'd put in a dresser normally, things that you don't hang up, will go in these bins. And then there's some open bins at the bottom where there's just some boxes and things like that stored, little weights. And, you could put shoes in the bottom or whatever you want. And again, these are Amazon purchases, these little bins. They're not too bad. They're flimsy. They're cheaper ones, but they look pretty nice in here. Kind of gives that black and white look. They're kind of gray, but they still, I think, kind of fit the theme that she was looking for in here. Underneath the loft, so there's LED lights underneath there. I'll show you those in a minute. But we did purchase another, this is another Amazon. It was a Christmas gift for her. And this is actually a fold-out bed. It's this little tiny couch with a fold-out bed in it. I don't know what size the bed is. It's a smaller bed, but it's perfect for the kids for sleepovers and all that stuff. Of course, we have the bed up top here that I'll show you in a minute. And then we can fold this out and have a guest stay, or the kids can have sleepovers and stuff like that, and have extra beds to deal with. You know, originally my thought was to put a desk under here, and something like the desk that we have actually up front here. This desk and chair could be easily fit underneath there. But again, with this, we have the option to pull that out and get an extra bed out of the deal. And over here, this is a little curtain here, just hung by command strips, Velcro strips, and just kind of separates the closet out from the rest of the room. But this is the actual closet, I guess you could say, where all of her clothes are hung. And another Amazon purchase was these hangers. So this allows you to just take advantage of smaller closet space, and you can actually hang down. So each hanger hangs on the next hanger, and it gives you another layer. So she actually has room to hang, a couple more layers of these down further. But so you can use that to organize your clothes. Like she has, three sweatshirts hung together here. But that just gives you a whole bunch more space. And you can see that there's a lot more space in here for her to hang more clothes with those hangers. We actually have more of those hangers. The pack that you get on Amazon with these, they're like a velvet hanger. I think that they're plastic on the bottom and metal on the top. They seem to be pretty durable, but we got these in a 50 pack on Amazon. So she's really liked those. So all of the lighting underneath the loft is powered. This is 120 volt LED rope, another Amazon link there I'll put for this. It's been really good. It's lasted a long time. It's got a box we put in the back there that's wired into the switch. And then that rope just runs through, and I just drilled holes in the actual supports of the loft and brought it through. Now, the one thing is that those little clips that come with it here, a few of them have broken, and so we need to get some new clamps on there to prevent this from sagging. But the LED ropes themselves have been really durable, and it's very bright under there just with that one rope. And then the main light was just the old light that was in here, but we did add smart bulbs to that so she can change the color of those bulbs and fade them in and out and, all that kind of stuff right from her phone, which is pretty cool. The one thing that I wish I would have done differently, the supports for this loft, you can see the back support here. It turned out really nice, and I boxed this out. So there's a 4x4 behind there that holds up the support of the loft. You can kind of see it in that corner. And what I did was took 3/4 inch plywood, the same stuff I made the shelves out over the boxes here, and I boxed that support in. And you can see that this one here is just the bare 4x4 painted. They work just the same. The support is fine, but it looks a lot nicer boxed out like that back one. And so what I may do if I get the energy and time someday is just come back and box this post in, as well as this other post over here. Just box those in real nice, and they look bigger and beefier with that plywood box made around them. And all the bases of the posts were just trimmed around. I cut the flooring right around those, and then I put a piece of trim in just to cover up the gap in the flooring around the bottom of those posts. Now, the one bad thing going up these stairs, the disadvantage of them being painted white, as you can see, they show all of the dirt, as well as you can see all the handprints. That's where everybody, grabs on the wall as they come up. And so these walls get pretty dirty, and you can see up there, we gotta come through and clean those. They wouldn't be any less dirty if they were a different color. You just wouldn't be able to see it quite as much. And of course, the stairs being white, they also get dirty. And so what I think I would do if I were gonna do this project over was maybe even paint the top of these stairs black, to kind of match the checkerboard type look. That would kind of hide some of that dirt. You'd still have to clean them, but it wouldn't look quite as bad going up the stairs. The wall, I'm not sure there's too much you can do about that. You just have to clean it up, every couple months. So the stairs themselves are actually, they're almost 18 inches. I mean, they're 17 and a half inches or 17 3/4 inches here deep. And then I think that they were about 12 inches Yeah, so about 12 and a half inches on the inside. They're about 12 inches by 12 inches square on the inside of that. So they're a good size cubby and a good size stair. So they're real solid for kids running up and down there. So the loft itself has been very, very stable. And so I wouldn't change anything with how that was constructed. These are all 2x6s. They are mounted and screwed. The back supports are screwed right into the, all the studs on the wall going all the way across. And then this side is screwed into all the studs on that wall. So it is mounted right into this room, as well as having the 4x4s on the three corners here, here, and in the back corner there. And then there is no support in that back corner. That is just purely mounted to the wall in the back corner there. So, the 2x4 supports underneath here, and then the brackets, I'll put links to those brackets too over on Home Depot that hold the 2x4s. Those work really well. There's been no sagging or bending or bowing of anything. I did use an MDF panel for the bottom of the loft pan, which worked really well. That hasn't sagged or anything like that at all either. And the distance between the joists on this is about 13 inches. So they're not all exactly the same. I think I tried to kind of space them out right around 13 inches. So so there's not a lot of space for the wood to sag there anyway, which is pretty nice. So the one thing that people asked a lot was, how much distance is there from the ceiling to the bed? And there is 34 inches from the top of this bedpan right here to the ceiling. Now the bedpan does go in another inch or two, but with the actual mattress in here, so to the top of her mattress, you're looking at about 26 inches. Now this is a pretty thick mattress. You could get a thinner one, but about 26 inches of space up there. And for a kid, you know, we have a 13-year-old in here right now, and she fits up, she can sit up in here with no problem. It's very comfortable, and you could get a thinner mattress and gain a couple inches that way also. This was designed for a queen size mattress up here, but we have a full mattress in here right now. And so it's a little bit smaller. You'll notice some extra space at the end and along the sides here. And going up into the loft here, one of the favorite things of my daughter that's in here right now is that outlet. It's another Amazon purchase. And that outlet's nice because it has the USB ports built right into it. So you can just plug your phone and tablet right in there. You don't have to worry about having a little adapter box, a little USB adapter for it. And then it still frees up the other outlets if you have other things to plug in. So, and what do you think the most asked question it was about this renovation? Where is the railing? That was the, everyone, why don't you have a railing? You have to have a railing. You should have a railing. Got a lot of comments about that. So yes, we do not have a railing on the edge of this bed. It is about a 4 foot drop to the floor, 4 or 5 foot drop. But we chose to leave the railing off. And I know that by code, and if we want to sell the house or something like that, we would have to go back and put a railing on here. Now I wanted to put, and probably will eventually put black pipe railing, a black steel pipe railing on here with the flanges coming off the edge and just going up maybe, I don't know, 12 inches or 14 inches or something like that, just to give a little place to grab if you were starting to roll off. Now we do have older kids though, and so we have taught them to be careful and not goof around up there and to stay, you know, away from the edge. We don't let the kids sleep, you know, right at the edge or whatever. They sleep back towards the back. And so that has been fine. You know, they're only going to fall off once and then they'll learn their lesson, right? No, I'm kidding. We don't want our kids to fall off there, but the railing hasn't been an issue. The biggest complaint with putting a railing on here was that the way that we have this set up, if you're sitting up here on the bed and you want to watch TV, you don't want to have a big railing, you know, sitting up there in your way. And so that was the biggest reason that we probably didn't put one up there, although we probably should at some point. Well, after a few years, it's held up pretty well. And so hopefully you guys enjoyed the update. If you've been following along, or if you're watching this, you know, the renovation videos and you're looking to do something like this, hopefully this helped you guys out. But the way that this was constructed it's just super solid. I mean, this thing doesn't budge, doesn't move, doesn't flex. You can put as many kids up there as you can fit in the bed, or adults, or whatever you wanted to. You got lots of room with a queen size bed up here. I mean, if you really wanted to pack kids in here for a sleepover, you can fit 3 or 4 kids in a queen size bed, and then plus 1 or 2 kids on the couch bed down below. And so This room, for being as small as it is, can really fit a lot. You could put a desk underneath for studying. You could have much more storage even underneath the closet over here. I mean, we didn't even tap into a lot of corners of this room. We could have added even more storage. And so, but really making use of an 8x11 room and making it a comfortable space, and feels a lot bigger than that when you're in here for even one or two kids to live. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the tour today. Of course, don't forget to hit thumbs up. Even if you didn't enjoy the tour, hit thumbs up anyway, it'd be cool. Subscribe to the SSL Family Dad channel if you wanna tag along and follow along. Lots more DIY projects like this. We're doing a lot of renovating things this year, fixing things up, mostly utility stuff, furnaces and water heaters and water piping and all kinds of electrical and things like that. And so if you'd like to tag along for those things, I'd love to have you subscribe and hit the bell, be notified for new videos when they come out. And as always, guys, thanks for watching. Have a good one.